हाँ हाँ
Good morning, all. So in last class, I explained about heat energy. Just I gave the definition and some units of heat energy only was given. And today I will explain some more points about heat energy and also the important term I explained today, that is temperature. So and the relation between heat energy and temperature and the different scales we use to measure the temperatures. All the points we can discuss today. Okay. Now, so all the first year students, all of you can send me the answers. If you ask the question, all of you can send me the answer through chatting only here, in live chatting only. Okay. There is one option, live chat. Okay, see here. When we all know that we have, we can categorize the substances into three types only. So solids, liquids, and gases. And all of you also know that how the molecules are existed inside the solids and liquids and gases. For example, I will just give you a small information about that, very simple information about that. Based on that, I will explain that about the temperature also. Okay. Now, in case of solids, if I consider, all the molecules are very close to each other. The general structure I'm drawing here. They are very close to each other and there is some small separation, even then completely they are not in contact. Definitely there is some small separation between the lattice structure. I think all of you know in chemistry about the lattice structure. So, but even in solids, you may think that the molecules are at rest only, but it is not true. The molecules in case of solids always vibrate about some mean position. For example, this molecule, if I consider, this molecule is not at rest, just it will vibrate about some mean position here. The mean position only we have drawn here. And this also will just move and just vibrate like this. So whenever they're vibrating, and also in case of solids, we can observe here that there is some interaction between these two molecules. That's why they're vibrating here, na? If there is no interaction, if there are no forces, what will happen? Each and every molecule will become individual and they will move apart from each other. That will happen in case of gases. But in case of solids, if I consider, what type of energies we can mention here for the molecules? The molecule is vibrating. It is vibrating in the sense, it is moving in the sense, it associates kinetic energy. What type of energy the molecule will have? Kinetic energy. And also the molecules will have potential energy because they are moving under some forces. So that they also have some potential energy. That means the molecules in case of solids, they have both kinetic energy and potential energy. In the same way, in case of liquids, they will have both kinetic energy and potential energy. When it comes to gases, these molecules do not have interactive forces when it comes to ideal gas only. Whenever they have no interactions, what will happen? The molecules will randomly move in all the directions. And in such case, they have completely kinetic energy. And potential energy may be zero in case of ideal gases. But when it comes to real gases, there are some interactions between the molecules. But in general, in any substance, even it may be solid or liquid or gas, whatever may be the substance, in all the three types of substances, we can observe here, they associate with some kinetic energy and potential energy. They are having some energies. And this total energy, that means total kinetic energy plus total potential energy. Total kinetic energy of our molecules plus total potential energy of all molecules in a substance is said to be, that is called as internal energy. What is it called? It is called as internal energy. So just I mentioned all these points to just know about internal energy only. So every particular substance or any system, anything definitely will have some type of internal energy. Why does internal energy come to the system? Because of kinetic energy and potential energy of molecules inside the substance. Okay, so that is about internal energy. But here, this internal energy, some part of this internal energy will be in the form of heat energy. That's why I mentioned this point. Our discussion is about heat energy, na? Our discussion is not about internal energy here. That will come in the next part of the chapter. But now, our discussion is about heat energy. Why does heat energy come in some particular system? Because every system has some internal energy, then most part of the internal energy will be in the form of heat energy. So what will happen to the heat energy? This heat energy or internal energy, for example, two bodies come in contact. For example, if I just rub my two hands here, so this part of the body and this part of the body will have some internal energy only. Are you able to listen the voice now? Now you can listen the voice. Okay. So temperature means what we can explain. Just I will repeat the same points whatever I explained in last 10 minutes. So I think there was a problem in voice here. So when it comes to substances, we can categorize the substances into three types. What are the three types? Solids, liquids, and gases. In all these three substances, solids, liquids, and gases, what we can understand that in all of these, the molecules will have different interactive forces in different substances. When it comes to solids, their molecules are bounded to each other. And that means they are having both kinetic energy and potential energy because they vibrate. And in the second case, in case of liquids, there are now, so to explain about degree of hotness or coldness, the amount of heat energy we cannot calculate, but we can just compare the amount of heat energy in different bodies only. Okay, so that particular factor, to compare the amount of heat energy in two different bodies, we just have taken new quantity called temperature. The temperature is nothing but the degree of hotness or coldness is called temperature. The degree of hotness or coldness is called temperature. Okay? చూడండి మధ్యలో వాయిస్ కట్ అయింది సో ఐ విల్ రిపీట్ ద పాయింట్స్ నో ప్రాబ్లం ఓకే సో చూడండి ఒకసారి ఓకే సో జస్ట్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ హియర్ అబౌట్ టెంపరేచర్ అండ్ టు మెజర్ ద టెంపరేచర్ ఇన్ ఎనీ పర్టికులర్ బాడీ ఇన్ వన్ పర్టికులర్ బాడీ ఇఫ్ ఐ వాంట్ టు మెజర్ ద టెంపరేచర్ సో హియర్ here we can have different scales also so what is the instrument we use to measure the temperature generally to measure the temperature we use the instrument which is called as thermometer is the instrument which we use to measure the temperature okay now so we have a different type of scales to use the thermometer one by one all the scales I will explain here okay to measure the temperature here what will happen when heat energy is given when heat energy is supplied to any particular body then let me consider this body is going to expand here it is expanding here for example okay so when this particular body is kept at freezing point of water this body may have some particular size and one more simple example we can consider what we are really using there we are really using generally thermometers that is mercury only na let me consider mercury is filled in this particular one okay mercury is filled in this particular container for example when this particular container is placed at freezing point of water in the sense wherever water converts into ice just the critical point between ice and water phase it is just in between ice and water phase this is in between ice and water phase okay Okay, when just ice converts into water, at that particular point, if I keep the body, if I keep the mercury column, then you can observe that in the mercury column, there is a particular level here. There is a particular level here. Okay, so if any disturbance is there, definitely I will repeat, don't call me again and again. Okay, please remember that. If there is any disturbance, definitely I will repeat the concept. Okay, there is no problem. First, try to listen the concept only. All of you understand? Okay, now. So whenever it is kept at ice and water point, freezing point of water, then let me consider the mercury is showing some level here. Can I? Okay, and whenever the heat energy is continuously supplied and at the boiling point of water, if I just keep the same substance, what will happen then at the boiling point of water? At the boiling point of water, definitely the mercury will expand. Whenever heat energy is supplied, what will happen to the mercury? That liquid will just expand, it may reach to other level. So at freezing point, the same amount of mercury will show some level in a tube, and at boiling point of water it will just show the other level. So when I just consider the gap between these two, the gap shows or it represents the expansion between freezing point of water and boiling point of water. So they just calibrated here as the boiling point, the freezing point of water, or freezing point of water, whatever it is taken. At that particular freezing point of water, we have taken here the mercury. That was taken 0. And the boiling point of water was taken 100. Here the two values were considered for both of them. One was taken 0 and other was taken 100 for our convenience. And the gap between these two, the gap or expansion between boiling point and freezing point is there, na? That difference can be divided into 100 parts. That was divided into 100 parts. And each part is named as, 1 centigrade. What is it called? Each part was named as 1 centigrade. Okay? Okoka part ki vaadu 1 centigrade annaramma. All of you understand this? So, to measure, we cannot measure the amount of heat energy, but we can measure the degree of hotness or coldness, that is temperature. To measure that, what are the reference points we have taken? We have taken the reference points, that is freezing point of water and boiling point of water. Freezing point of water in the sense, at that particular position where ice converts into water or water converts into ice, at that critical point, if I just keep a mercury column at that particular position, the mercury shows some level. You have to mark that level. And then you have to bring the same mercury tube and you have to keep at boiling point of water where water converts into vapor. Here water converts into vapor. In this particular case, you can mark the mercury level also. And here, the gap between these two particular values, freezing point level and boiling point level of mercury, in both the cases, the difference can be divided into 100 parts, and each part was named as 1 centigrade. That is generally represented as 1 degree Celsius. Each part was taken 1 degree Celsius. In another type of scale, we can divide the freezing point and boiling point level difference into 180 parts. Okay, so if I consider another type of scale, for example, this is the thermometer. If I consider, and there is some mercury level up to this point, for example, initially in Celsius scale, what we have taken, this was taken 0, and what was the max boiling point? This was taken 100. From 0 to 100, we can divide them like this. We can just write that. This 0 is unknown. This may be 10, 20, 30, 40, 100 varaku rasukuntam. In the same way, the same gap between these two things, if they are divided into 100 parts, what is the scale I mentioned? If it is divided into 100 parts, that scale was mentioned as centigrade scale. And if it is divided into 180 parts, and there is also one more type of division where the gap between freezing point of water, and this indicates boiling point of water, and the same difference, the same length can be divided into 180 parts also. If it is divided into 180 parts, then it is called as Fahrenheit scale. That is simply Fahrenheit scale. Okay, so we have used here two basic scales. What are the two? What I explained for the two? One is centigrade scale and other is Fahrenheit scale. Okay, in case of centigrade scale, you just see here, the freezing point of water and boiling point of water was divided into 100 parts. And in other type of scale, they divided into 180 parts. Okay, so based on that, the scales were calibrated. But for Fahrenheit scale, but finally we are following here all the three scales we use here. Kelvin scale also we use here. But for centigrade scale, lower part is indicated with 0. Upper part is indicated with 100. But for Fahrenheit scale, lower part is not 0. Lower part was taken 32. And upper part was taken 212. And the difference is 180 only. No? This is called lower fixed points. These two are called. And these two are called upper fixed points. What are the two? Lower fixed points and upper fixed points. And also there is one more type of scale which we use for scientific and research purpose. And in science, everything we learn, mostly all the points we learn in terms of Kelvin. What is the third type of scale? It is Kelvin scale. And in Kelvin scale also, it is just like centigrade scale only. But the lower part is not Fahrenheit, sorry. Lower part is not freezing point of water. So, as I said earlier, in case of solids, what will happen? Solids, liquids or gases, molecules are having some different distances in different cases. So, whenever temperature decreases, what will happen to those molecules? When temperature decreases, the molecules will come very close to each other. In such a way, when temperature becomes very, very less, what will happen? They will come very, very close. And at one particular position, we can say that there is no possibility for further compression. These gases or solids, whatever it is, they all will come to some maximum compression. And further, we don't have any compression. In such case, the temperature is said to be -273 degrees Celsius. That is said to be absolute temperature. What is the absolute temperature? That is the reference we consider in case of Kelvin. Okay, so on the game, yes, under the absolute temperature is -273.15 degrees Celsius. When we compare these two, here also we just divide into 100 parts, so it is just like Celsius scale only. There is no much difference between these two. Only the difference is starting point. Here the starting point is zero, but here the starting point is -273.15 degrees Celsius when you compare these two. In such a way, for our convenience, for their convenience, the scientists have just calibrated these three important type of scales. What are the three important type of scales we are having? Centigrade scale, Fahrenheit scale, and Kelvin scale. Where do we generally use? For example, centigrade scale is taken. So centigrade scale, generally we use centigrade in representing the temperatures of weather. Weather report, if you see weather report in TV channels, then you can see that they give the maximum temperature is 42 degrees Celsius, minimum temperature is 28 degrees Celsius, like that. Always they express in terms of degrees Celsius. The general temperatures we can express only in terms of degrees Celsius. But if anybody gets some fever, if a thermometer is used, generally we tell that the temperature is 98, 99, 100, something like that. 100 degrees Celsius if it is, that is much more. We cannot bear more than 50 degrees Celsius. How can you bear 100 degrees Celsius? So that means that thermometer to measure the temperature of a person, we won't express in terms of degrees Celsius. We express in terms of Fahrenheit scale. Okay, in Fahrenheit scale it will be 98, 99, 100 Fahrenheit it is, not 100 degrees Celsius, our body temperature. To express the weather report, we generally use centigrade scales. To express the body's temperature, generally we use Fahrenheit scale. And where do we use Kelvin scale? Kelvin scale will be used in when you want to solve some problem or solve some question by using some equation. Definitely we have to, in that equation temperature is there, one quantity temperature is there in that equation. If you substitute, definitely you should use in terms of Kelvin only. You should not substitute the values in terms of degree Celsius or Fahrenheit, because all the scientific purpose or research purpose, we express temperatures only in terms of Kelvin scale. Because some cases we have to express -270, -250, like that we have to express. So generally they consider the lower -273.15 degree Celsius is called as zero Kelvin. Antakante takku unte em avutundi sir ante antakante takku kuna velle ala velthe maximum freeze aipo maximum compress aipothayi. That means the molecules are ceases to compress there. Antak minchinta takku volume ku velladu. So that this is only the maximum or minimum temperature. This is only the minimum temperature we can achieve. That is called as zero Kelvin. We can never express minus in terms of Kelvin. In terms of degree Celsius Fahrenheit, we can just mention the negative values. But in case of Kelvin, we can never mention negative values. All of you understand? So here, about three scales I explained. If the freeze, what are the reference points generally? Generally, the reference points were taken freezing point of water and boiling point of water. The distance between freezing point and boiling point of water can be divided into 100 parts or 180 parts. If it is divided into 100 parts, that is centigrade scale. It is divided into 180 parts, that is Fahrenheit scale. And the Kelvin scale is related to centigrade scale only. The divisions are 100 here, 100 here also. But the difference is lowest point is different. -273.15 degrees Celsius is called as zero Kelvin. These scales are okay. But what we see here generally, here I explained you that which is increasing here. The mercury level is increasing only. No? The level of mercury is increasing. Why should we use such type of mercury only? Because for mercury, it is the level of mercury in a very thin tube. The expansion of mercury is directly proportional to the amount of heat energy. For example, what is the unit for heat energy? Joules, calories, years, anything you can consider. But in general, for heat energy, we use calories. For example, 2 calories of heat energy if I supply here, then it increases by 5 degrees Celsius, for example. If I supply 2 calories, then again some more 5 degrees it will increase. If 4 calories is supplied, then definitely 10 degrees Celsius it will increase. That means the level of mercury, the expansion of mercury, is always directly proportional to, it is directly proportional to amount of heat energy we supply. So it will have some uniform variation along with heat energy when it is kept in thin tube only. So that mercury is the best one also. For mercury, it is having high thermal conductivity. Mercury is always having some high thermal conductivity. That means the response to the heat energy, thermal conductivity means how quickly it will respond to the supplied heat energy. So that is more for mercury. So mercury is the best option for liquid thermometers. This is only for liquid thermometers. Of course, we have so many other types of thermometers also. Gaseous thermometers we will have, and about resistance thermometers we are having. So such type of different thermometers we are having. But here I explained, and I have taken an example, only the liquid thermometer. All of you understand here? Here just again I will explain all the points what I mentioned in the class. First of all, just I will repeat that, because in first 15 minutes the voice was not clear, so that I will just repeat that. Okay, so when it comes to different type of substances, solids, liquids and gases, in all these cases the molecular arrangement will be different. So in case of solids, they are having more potential energy because of interactions between the molecules. They are having more potential energy and some amount of kinetic energy also because of their vibration. In liquids and gases also, because of their motion and interactions, all the molecules are having kinetic energy and potential energy. So inside the body, whatever the total kinetic energy and potential energy is there, the total energy is called as total kinetic energy plus total potential energy. That is called as internal energy. That internal energy can be transferred from one body to other body when there is some difference of energies. So that we mentioned in terms of temperature, of course. So that is the first point I mentioned. Okay, next one. But we can never calculate the amount of heat energy inside the body or amount of internal energy inside the body. But we can calculate only the amount of heat transfer, amount of energy transfer only we can calculate. So that to compare the two bodies, the amount of heat energy we have to compare in two bodies. For the comparison, we can use the word temperature here, and the definition of temperature we can write it as degree of hotness or degree of coldness is called temperature. Okay, and to measure the temperature or to calculate the scales of temperature, we take the reference points, which are freezing point of water and boiling point of water. Freezing point of water in the sense between ice phase and water phase. Boiling point of water in the sense between water and vapor phase. Whenever the critical point you have to consider between water and vapor phase. If I just keep some mercury column, why should we use mercury only? Mercury is having high thermal conductivity and its response to the heat energy will be uniform in between these temperatures, not in all the cases. Between 0 to 100, definitely the expansion will be uniform. So that we use mercury here. When some mercury liquid in some thin tube, if it is kept at freezing point of water, the level of mercury you have to mark here. And when it is kept at boiling point of water, then also we have to mark the level of that. Then we can just divide the difference between these two points into 100 equal parts. When it is divided into 100 equal parts, that scale was named as centigrade scale, and the values are taken at 0 and 100. Lower value was taken 0 and upper value was taken 100. And at other place, the same concept was used to calibrate the Fahrenheit scale only, so that to compare both of them, we can use some relation also here. And when you compare with centigrade scale, in case of Fahrenheit scale, how many divisions will be there? In case of Fahrenheit scale, there will be 180 divisions. And lower fixed point will be 32, and upper fixed point will be 212. That means 180 parts were divided. And Kelvin scale is also just like centigrade scale only. Only 100 parts will be there. But the problem is, and the difference is, what is the difference here? Here in case of Kelvin scale, the lower point is not 0 degrees Celsius. Lower point is not freezing point of water. We consider another point, that is absolute temperature. This is called absolute temperature. What is the value of absolute temperature? -273.15 degree Celsius. That is the absolute temperature. Okay. So not only the mercury level, we can also use here when gas is used in the thermometer. Then you can use the variation of pressure or variation of volume. And in some cases, we can take a resistance which varies with the temperature. All these factors we can consider to calibrate the thermometer. What are the different factors we can use to calibrate the thermometer? One is mercury column or liquid column we can use, first point. And the second point you can use, if you use some gas, the variation of pressure with heat energy, variation of volume with heat energy, and resistance of the material with heat energy. All these factors you can consider to calibrate the temperature scales. And tomorrow I will explain about all the remaining factors also. Okay? Thank you.